I welcome you all again to my video lecture. Now in this video lecture I have started discussing questions regarding SSC CGL. Now the very first question, which is written below the video, there are around 5 or 6 questions in this particular audio lecture, and I am going to make more audio lectures in which you are going to get more questions for your practice. So I hope that you have read the question. Now I will start solving it. It is saying that the price of petrol has increased by 25%. So suppose the price of petrol is P and it has increased by 25%. Increase. So how much it will become? It will become something like this. P into 1 plus 25 by 100. What is this P into 1 plus 25 by 100? It is P into 1 plus 1 by 4, which becomes 5 by 4. That is the initial price of petrol was P rupees per liter, and finally it became 5 by 4. Now suppose that you go to a petrol station and you purchase 5 liters of petrol and you pay around 50 rupees per liter. So how much do you pay totally? For 1 liter you give 50 rupees per liter. So for 5 liters you will give 550 rupees. That is, your expenditure will be 250 rupees. Now on this particular question, it is saying that expenditure doesn't have to change. So first of all, I will write what is expenditure. Expenditure is price into consumption. This is what expenditure is, price into consumption. Now what was initially the price? P. So I write it as P. And what was initially the consumption? I assume it as C. So the expenditure initially was E. It was P into C. These are assumed variables. Now it is saying that in the second case the expenditure remains constant. So expenditure is E only. But the price becomes 25% more. That is, it becomes 5 by 4P. So I will write it here as 5 by 4P. And suppose I have to calculate that by how much the consumption has to be reduced. So previously the consumption was C. I suppose it becomes C1 now. So this has to be equals to this. This P into C and 5 by 4 P into C1. So this has to be equals to this. So in order to make both of these things equal, we have to equate them. So what is here? It is saying that P into C is equals to 5 by 4 P into C1. So I write it as P into C equals to 5 by 4 P into C1. This P, P gets, this P and P gets cancelled out. So what is remaining? C is equals to 5 by 4 into C1. Now what will be the value of C1 in terms of C? 4 by 5C. This is of importance. This C1, that is the final consumption, came out 4 by 5th of the initial consumption. That is, if petrol increased by 25%, and by saying 25%, I am saying 1 by 4. So if the petrol increased by 1 by 4, it became 5 by 4. So consequently, this quantity consumption became 4 by 5. I have proved it here. This. So initially it was C, now it became 4 by 5C. So from C, it came to 4 by 5C. So how will we calculate the percentage decrease? Initially it was C, after that it became 4 by 5C. So the percentage decrease will be, C, that was initial quantity, minus 4 by 5C. That is final quantity, upon C, that is initial quantity, into 100. This is the way of doing things. And when you will calculate, it will come out as 20% decrease. So simply, what we got to know, that if a quantity increased by 25%, that is increased by 1 by 4, that is, it becomes 5 by 4 of the initial quantity. So the quantity that we have to decrease, it became 4 by 5. And when it became 4 by 5, I calculated it, the percentage decrease, which came out as 20%. from C to it became 4 by 5C, so there was a decrease of 1 by 5C. 1 by 5C is 20%. You all know that. I have already told you in the percentage lecture. So I hope this thing is clear to you. There is one more method of doing this thing. Now in my video lecture I told you one method. One shortcut or one formula you can say, and that formula was A plus B plus AB by 100. These videos are recorded, so obviously you can again listen to them again and again, so that if anyone is not able to understand this question in the one go, it can understand it by listening it again. I told you about this A plus B plus AB by 100. What was this? This was a percentage increase. Or what was this? This was a successive percentage increase. Now using this concept, if I say that A plus B plus AB by 100, if I suppose this A is the percentage increase in petrol, which is 25, and I suppose this B is the percentage decrease in consumption, but I don't know the value, so I write it only B, then A 25 into B by 100. Now this is the overall percentage increase. In what? In expenditure. But expenditure is not increased, so the overall percentage increase is equals to 0. So by this, we are going to calculate the value of B, and this B will be the decrease in the value of consumption. Let us solve this. Solving this, we will get minus of 20% discount. What does this minus signify? This minus signify that there has been a decrease. So this is the second way of doing this thing. I am directly solving this thing. I am not telling you the detailed method or the detailed method, the detailed concept. I have told you in the percentage lecture. Kindly watch the percentage lectures. Next question. Again and again watch these videos. They are very helpful. The next question is, cost price of 20 articles is equal to selling price of 16 articles. So I suppose the cost price of one article is C and selling price is S. So what is this saying? The cost price of 20 articles. If the cost price of one article is C, then the cost price of 20 articles will be 20C. And if the selling price of one article is S, then the selling price of 16 articles will be 16S. And the question it is saying that these two things are equal. Different methods of solving this thing. One is the longer method, one is the shorter method. First look at the longer method. This 20C is equals to 16S. Now suppose that this 20C is equals to 16S is equals to arbitrary quantity K. Now I will write the value of C in terms of K. C becomes K by 20 and S becomes K by 16. Now what is the cost price of one article in terms of K? It is K by 20. What is the cost price of one article? What is the selling price of one article in terms of K? It is K by 16. Now what does the question says? The question says, what is the percentage profit or loss made by the merchant? Now the point is that he has not told us the quantity of the articles sold, but it doesn't matter. The profit percentage or the loss percentage we are going to get on the sale of one article will be equal to the profit percentage we will get on the sale of 100 articles or 200 articles or 400 articles, it doesn't matter. So cost price of one article K by 20, selling price of one article K by 16. So how are we going to calculate? Now let us see, what is it? Is it profit or is it loss? This K is K, in the numerator is constant. In the denominator of cost price, we had to have 20. In the denominator of selling price, we are having 16. So obviously this quantity is bigger. This S is equals to K by 16 is bigger. So if S is equals to K by 16 is bigger, so obviously the selling price is a bit higher. And if selling price is a bit higher, then it is profit. So the profit would be, what is the formula? Selling price minus cost price upon cost price into 100. This is the formula. Okay? Now, I am writing the formula. Exact values K by 16 minus K by 20 upon K by 20 into 100. This we have to solve. Let's solve it. What will be the LCM of 16 and 20? It will be 80. So I write here 80. This is 5k minus 4k and here k by 20 into 100. So solving this, what we will get? We will get it somewhere like k upon 80 upon k by 20, which will be something like this. 1 by 4 into 100, 25% profit. Excuse me, friends. Longer method. Now let us assume the shorter method. Cost price of 20 is equal to selling price of 16. So what I am going to do, I am going to take the LCM of 20 and 16. What is the LCM of 20 and 16? 80. Now I am going to assume that this 20C is equal to 16S is equal to P/Z/T. By assuming this, what we are going to get? We are going to get the cost price of one article is equal to 80 by 20, that is 4. And what we are going to get? I am going to get the selling price of one article is equals to 80 by 16, that is rupees 5. So the cost price of one article is 4, cost selling price of one article is 5. So what will be the profit percentage? Selling price minus cost price upon cost price into 100. That is 5 minus 4 upon 4 into 100, it becomes 25% profit. Same answer. This is a bit short method, this is a bit long method. You can always expect questions like this in SSC CGL. If you get questions like this, this is the method to move forward, not this. This is a bit time taking. This method is an oral calculation, and even if you will write, it will take not more than 20 seconds. So now let us look at the next question. Twice as much as Maria. Maria's weight is 60% of Bob's weight. So I suppose that the weight of Bob is X. This is my supposition. I suppose that the Bob weight is X. What is told in the second line that Marcia's weight is 60% of Bob's weight. So if Bob weight is X, Marcia's weight will be 0.60X. 60% 0.60X. Now the first line. John weighs twice as much as Maria. So So if John weighs twice as much as Maria, Maria weighs 0.60, so he weighs 1.20x. Next one, Dave weighs 50% of Lee's weight. We don't know Lee's weight. Then next question, Lee weighed 190% of John's weight. So what is John's weight? It is 1.20x. And Lee's weight is 1.190% of John's weight. So it will be 1.90 into 1.20x. Now we should calculate it. It will be somewhere around 2.28x. So the weight of Lee is around somewhere around 2.28x. Now, Dave weighs 50% of Lee's weight. Dave weighs 50% of Lee's weight. So if Lee's weight is 2.28x, 50% of this will be half of this. So it becomes 1.14x. So these are relative quantities of the respective weights of these persons in terms of x. Now what is the question? The question is that which of these five persons weighs the least? Which of these five persons weighs the least? You can easily see 1.20x, 0.6x, x, 1.414x, 2.28x, the least is 0.60x. Obviously, x cannot be a negative quantity because this is weight. So, the least is Marcia. The answer of the third question is Marcia. Okay, coming on to the next question, question number 4. By 10 marks. So how many marks he got? He got 30% of the total marks. Now suppose the total marks are x. M. So what will be the 30% of m? 13 to m by 100. So it will become 0.30. So the marks obtained by Peter are 0.30. And what are the marks obtained by Paul? 40% of the total marks. So Paul has scored 0.40. Now what does it say? It says that Peter failed the examination by 10 marks. By saying that Peter has failed the examination by 10 marks, we mean that Peter has scored 10 marks less than the passing marks. So if Peter scored 10 marks less than the passing marks, so what will be the passing marks? It will be 0.30m plus 9. Because Peter has failed by 10 marks, that means that he has scored 10 marks less than the passing marks. So if he has scored this quantity, 0.30m, this is 10 less than the passing marks. So if we add 10 to this, we will get the passing marks. Coming here, for Paul it has told that he has got 15 marks more than the passing marks. That means this quantity is 15 more than the passing marks. So in this case, what will be the passing marks? It will be 15 less than 0.40m. So in terms of Peter's numbers, the passing marks are 0.30m plus 10. In terms of Paul's numbers, the passing marks are 0.40m minus 15. We have to equate these two quantities. So by equating these two quantities, we are getting plus 10 is equals to 0.40m minus 15. Well, the passing marks in both the cases will be same. It will come out somewhere as 0.10m is equals to 25 and m as 250. So the total marks, maximum marks have been calculated as 250. What we have to calculate? We have to calculate the passing marks. The question says that what are the passing marks in the examination? So obviously, we have to calculate the passing marks in the examination. What are the passing marks? These are the passing marks. we can calculate the passing marks by putting the value of m in either of these two quantities. When we put the value m here as 250, we multiply this 0.3 into 250, we will get 75. And 75 plus 10 will become 85. Similarly here, if I am going to place this 250 in this m, we will get as 100, and 100 minus 15 will come as 85. So the passing marks are 85. Answer. Next question. First day, next day. These two stay. First day, 60% apples sold. So obviously, how many are remaining? 60%, 40% are remaining. Okay. Question says these have been sold. These are remaining. Now it says of the remaining these, 15% he has thrown away. Of the remaining, 15% is thrown away. So how many are remaining? 40%. And what will be 15% or 40%? It will be 40% into 15 by 100. Which will come out as 6%. 40% were remaining on the first day. Of these 40%, 50% have been thrown away. So what is 15% of 40%? 40% into 15 by 100. That comes out 6%. That is 6%. Thrown away on first day. No, 60% sold, 6% thrown away. So 66% gone. How many are remaining? 34% remaining after the first day. 60% sold, they are already gone. 6% thrown away. So how many are remaining? 34% are remaining. Now on the second day he is saying that 50% of the remainder, he sells 50% of the remainder and throws 50%. So out of this 34%, 50% he sells and 50% he throws away. So what is 50% of 34%? It is 17%. 50% is half. So half. 50% of 34% he sells. So he sells 17% and the rest he throws away. So is 17% throws away. So on the first day he thrown away 6%, on the second day he thrown away 17%. So the question is, what percentage of his apples does the vendor throw? On the first day he throws 6%, on the second day he throws 17%. So he throws 6 plus 17, 23%. So the answer is 23% he throws away. 23% of his apples. Easy one. I'm going on in a fast way. You can always rewind back and listen the videos. If you have doubts, you can post them in the comment section. I will reply to them. Again, this is a petrol question. It says that the price of the petrol is being increased by 25%, and the person wants to increase his expenditure only by 15%. So how much should he reduce his expenditure, his consumption? So again, I am going to tell you by shortcut. You have read the question, A plus B plus AB by 100 is the final percentage change. What we are getting as the final percentage change? 15%. So this A plus B plus AB by 100 is 15. So I'm going to suppose this A is 25% and this B is consumption. A is profit percentage, B is consumption. So this becomes 25 plus B plus AB by 100. I'm sorry, in place of this A, I will write as 25 is equals to 15. Solving it, I will get B by B by 4 is equals to minus of 10. So B will come out as minus of 8. So the consumption decreases by 8%. Consumption decreases by 8%. So the answer is 8%. The question was, by how much percent we should reduce the quantity of petrol purchased? Obviously, reduction in the consumption is 8%. So friends, in this video I have told you 6 questions of percentages, more to come. Please check the website regularly, my blog. The blog address is written at the top, gs-india.blogspot.in.